Welcome to Couch Critics, a show where we review and react to hit shows and movies from the comfort of our couch to yours. I'm your host, Gia Peppers, and today we're checking out the iconic show, Comic View, streaming March 14th on BET+, a show known for showing love to the freshest faces in comedy.
I believe that a man will give you anything and everything you want, need, and desire, as long as you don't ask him for nothing. Stop begging so much. You need a new refrigerator. Don't say nothing. Bring that man a hot glass of Kool-Aid.
Ladies is putting these wigs on like baseball hats now. They got to put a starter sign on the inside of your wig.
I'm a couch critic. You a couch critic. We some couch critics. We some couch critics.
We got three of the funniest people in the world right here. He's got the biggest black-owned comedy club in America and is on a world tour that's both called super funny, Nate Jackson. Next, she's a single female, and that's the name of her newest comedy special. Miss Daphne Springs is with us too. And from the internet streets to BET+, we've got the creator and star of Churchy, Mr. Kev on stage. I'm so excited that we get to talk today, especially about the importance of Comic View. And y'all represent three of the biggest voices in comedy. And today, we're going to get into the past and the future of comedy. So y'all ready to get into
Absolutely.
Do you all know each other?
Like, I know both of them.
Yeah.
I know Daphne from social media. We worked together at All Def, I believe.
Yes.
Yeah. And Nate, I started comedy at his club in Washington.
Oh, for real?
Nate gave me 15, 20 minutes a week. I didn't realize how valuable that was.
I actually known Kev from doing All Def, and also I did your Keep the Distance show.
So that's
the opportunity that he gave to me. And Nate, I've been in Nate's bed before, but we were shooting sketches.
Start the other way.
Yeah, just shooting sketches. That was it.
I had no problem with how she presented that.
We're going to celebrate just the presence of Comic View and the fact that it's coming back with new voices, new fresh faces. So are y'all excited about this comeback of Comic View?
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Well deserved.
What were some of those initial moments when you watched the show? Did that confirm for you that you wanted to do comedy?
What I loved about it is the Comic View name was so strong, you didn't have to know the comedians ahead of time. Mm. You knew Comic View was funny. So if they made Comic View, they were funny. I didn't know everybody who taped didn't make it at the time. I was like, man, there's so many funny people in the world. Like, these people are killing it. So I think just the brand identity alone, I'm all for more people knowing about black comedians. I mean, there's still comedians today, still on the road from Comic View 20, 25 years ago.
Absolutely.
So, literally.
It's huge.
Hey, your mother ever whoop you at school? Ever get your ass whooped at school? Don't act like I'm the only brother that happened to. Your mother come in with that old ass whoop robe on. Where he at? People be looking at you. That's your mama. Oh, I don't know. That ain't my ass. And mothers back then would whoop you with anything. Remember that Hot Wheel track ass whoop you ever had there? You didn't even want Hot Wheels. You want some Hot Wheels for Christmas? Hell no. Remember the Easy Bake? I love the Easy Bake oven. Remember when you get your gas cut off and around trying to cook a real meal in there?
My first joke was about getting whoopings. That's so funny.
Wow.
It was about how, and it was the best joke I had written at that time. I was 16. It was about how your parents would beat you and not take a break. They'd be like, didn't I tell you?
Yeah. Like, you don't talk that slow any other time.
Man.
Speed it up.
I had a joke like that early on too.
Yeah, we.
You I said because I came from a two-parent home.
Yeah.
So while my dad was going, my mom was like, "You did." In the middle, in the little gap.
We can talk about women's all day. We gotta get to the next clip.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna say this about police. You all remember this? If a police ever pull you over, ask for your driver's license insurance. Y'all know it's a known fact. If they ask for your driver's license insurance, ask you to get out of the car, you know you're going to jail. Police gonna pull me over right here in L.A. He gonna say, sir, can I see driver's license insurance? I said, yeah. I gave him to him. He said, can you get out of the car? I said, I ain't getting out of this car. He said, sir, I would tow this car in. I said, I ride in on the back of the record.
Bruce was the first comedy show I ever saw live in person.
Really?
Yep.
The first show I saw was
Florida.
Benji Brown. You said Benji Brown. He was at the homecoming for Florida Memorial College and destroyed, talking about Kiki.
An actual comedy club?
Yeah.
It might have been Nate's room. Like, in person?
Me?
Yeah. I saw, like, Kings of Comedy and, like, all the specials.
Oh, right.
But I mean, as an audience member sitting in the club, I didn't think of a time before I was at Nate's.
Wow.
That means it's me.
Yeah.
It was my room. I'm on stage.
Okay.
Would y'all like to hear the poem I wrote my ex-boyfriend? All right, check it out. It's dedicated to my ex-boyfriend. I'm not mad at him. And the name of it is Stab Your Black Ass. By Montana Angelou Taylor. You say the only woman you love is me. Stab your black ass. Stab your black ass. Then who all them hoes on your call ID? Stab your black ass. Stab your black ass. I gave you my love. I gave you my all. I co-signed for that car. You can't even call. Stab your black ass. Stab your black ass.
That's comic view to me. Mm. Like that. First of all, can you imagine that on TikTok?
Right.
Yeah,
that would have 40
ass.
Million views
right
the
now.
First day. Like, that's, I don't remember that clip, but that's how funny Comic View was. Because she just in her eyes, just how much her eyes popped up, that joke was not even 2 minutes long.
The amount of expansion that the show and how many people it reached gave perspective to the black culture. Mm-hmm. Nationwide. Yeah. I grew up in Washington State. You turn on Comic View, like, oh, okay. Like, you saw the flyest, freshest of that time.
Yeah.
Comic View, you turn it on and you see people that look like you, that are living your experience, and they're making your everyday life a I couldn't get that in Washington State, not with the Wahitis.
So, comedy's landscape has dramatically evolved, yet the journey for many emerging comedians still begins with the unmistakable, unshakable spotlight of the stage. This new season of Comic View shines a light on the fresh faces who are not just entering the stand-up scene, but are rapidly becoming its standout stars.
I used to give out public aid, food stamps, cash assistance, Medicaid, and I quit. I was like, I'm finna do comedy full time. We outside, baby, right? I was happy about that. Thank y'all. Thank y'all. And I quickly realized that I needed food stamps, cash assistance, and Medicaid. I was like, damn, life came right back around. Bit me in the ass. I'm all in the office like, I can skip the line or what? Like, that's why I used to sit next to you. What is we doing? Veronica, I go in your office and take all them cat posters down. Stop playing with me.
That's so relatable to me because when I first moved to Los Angeles, California, my grandmother lived in Inglewood, and she had a two-bedroom. My little cousin had just went to go stay back with her mother. She said, baby, you have it. It's a twin-size bed. I said, Grandma, that's all I need. And she took me first day up to the welfare office and got me some food stamps and said, baby, make sure you, this is the food I need you to bring in the house. So I said, Grandma, these your food stamps or my food stamps? I'm gonna be cooking, so you need to get, and I had food stamps when I first moved here.
There's some cougars out here, shit. There was a cougar in the back. Hey, auntie. I like them classified cougars. I like them cougars that still got them shoulder pads in their suit. What them? I like them cougars that still got that toilet seat cushion where you sit down, that be I almost just fell. The cougars had that scavenger hunt. They make you look for the coochie. You want this cootie cat, you better come find it.
Cootie cat is...
Yeah, who says cootie cat? Man, DC been bringing some heat, man. He the first one that was that I saw doing split screen roasts, giving us consistent stuff every day.
He was going every day.
And nobody would respond. And Kevin Durant opened the floodgates, and then it was him versus celebrities, and then everybody's like, well, he was a celebrity too.
Now he's sitting on hard toilet seats.
Bidets.
Okay, water splurting up the ass.
Yo!
You don't need to wipe.
You're doing it if you ain't got to wipe no more.
Y'all have been hilarious, and I could talk to you guys all day, but we do have to wrap this up. But thank you so much for being here. Y'all are incredible at what you do. Y'all make sure that you check out Comic View on BET Plus March 14th.